We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Phigments, Issue 1 from Amazing Comics. This was published by Amazing Comics, but it's printed by Pied Piper Press, and Issue 2 of this series is actually published by Pied Piper. Amazing Comics didn't last a real long time, unfortunately, but it's because their books were at least twice as much as other books on the market. That was really common with indie comics back then. This is from 87. So back in the 80s, printing was much more expensive, and if you wanted to publish your own book, it was going to cost you a lot of money. The $1.95 price point was exorbitant for the time for buying something off the newsstand, but if you wanted your book sold, that's the price you paid, and it's in black and white, and that did not help. Indies didn't really sell a whole lot, but nowadays you can have a professionally done indie book for the same cover price as a Marvel comic, and you'll probably have it on better paper and in color. Things have changed quite a bit, so don't hold it against a book if it's in black and white from the 80s, because coloring a book back then was way more expensive. There was no computer coloring technology that was cost effective until the mid to late 90s. Malibu Comics kind of revolutionized that. But this book is written by Alan Rowlands. Evan Dorkin and Jim Fern were the artists. Brosseau and Lopez were letterers. David Lawrence, editor. I don't know who did the cover, but I can see the name Dorkin and somebody else on there. I'm guessing Evan Dorkin and Jim Farron did the cover. That's what it looks like, but I can't read that second name, unfortunately. We got three convicts that do a jailbreak, and they kidnap this lady and force her to drive her car out. She ends up going off the road and crashing, and this guy saves her. He starts talking about God or something, and there's these guys that they're supposed to meet up with are out in the woods, and they find the car and accidentally blow it up, but the lady gets creeped out by all the talk of God, and she goes out on her own, where she's attacked by these ruffians, and then these creatures show up, and there's a little bit of a twist ending, but the creatures look kind of cool, and we learn what's up with them and what happened to the ex-cons. It was a pretty interesting twist. So I was actually thought the book was only okay. The storytelling needed a little work, but the pacing was good. The art's not bad. The lady's age tends to look a little weird throughout, so you can't tell how old she is. I'm guessing she's supposed to be in her early to mid 30s, but there are panels that make her look significantly older. So the art is a little unrefined, but it's not bad, even for the 80s, for an indie book. I've seen way worse, but it definitely is an indie level book. This is good quarterbin material. I didn't think it was the greatest thing I've ever read, but it certainly wasn't the worst, and it has more plot than Marvel Comics of the modern era, so there's that. But if you see it in a quarterbin, definitely pick it up. It's worth 25, 50 cents. I wouldn't feel bad paying a buck for it. There's only a couple issues in it in the series, so if you get a chance to pick it up, do so. If you find it cheap enough, because hey, why not? And out of a quarterbin, you could do a lot worse. So that being said, I would recommend this out of a cheap bin, but that's just my opinion. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and the about page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.